at this point. I'm just going to roll it. Get some of that junk out of there. So I got some place to put the stuff still. Oh yeah, this looks beautiful. All right, so while I got it rolled over, I'm gonna hit some of this on the top here because this will be easier than hitting it on the sawhorses, which is where I'm gonna put it to let it ultimately dry. So let's see how this goes. Yeah, that looks a lot better. Although it's a far cry from the red that it was probably 15 years ago. right, that hand's getting tired. Swap over here. Sorry about that. It's already looking a whole lot better. This side here doesn't look as bad because this was against the embankment and not as much as the sunlight got to it. So I think I'm gonna probably do a time lapse on this side. Alrighty. Oops. I can't put my finger and the camera. All right, let me try this again. All right, so let's see how this goes here. See there, that little scratch, that's the original color of the boat. I don't think that's ever coming back. Come on, roll. You can definitely tell that this is going to take more than one. I'll probably have to use soap in the next one. going to be a little bit of a fight. One here. This stuff here is really nasty. That's a mold that stayed there. I think that's staying. You get a little bit of it to wear down, but not much. That's cool. Model number of the boat. Pine pitch on there. Definitely a marked difference. Well, probably gonna lose the other sticker. So it's a Coleman Ram X15. My dad's name. It is carved right into there. Did that so I could keep the boat from getting stolen while it was parked up at a local pond. At least then somebody would have a phone number to get a hold of me on. Alrighty, I'm gonna crack at this. Get out of there. That's not even a sticker that belongs there. Finish this last bit. We'll give this thing a chance to rest. This is our little Karcher, 1700 PSI. So this is basically about as consumer as you can possibly get. So I could kind of smell the motor heating up on that bad boy. It's doing what I want it to do though. We're getting it covered. Only a little bit left to go. Then I'll hit the inside, put it up on the sawhorses, let her dry. So needless to say, this is the first time this boat has ever been cleaned since I got it. I've had this boat for, I don't know, 18, 19 years now. It's held up remarkably well considering it sits in the woods full time, sitting next to a pond. it goes in and out of the water, obviously, but beyond that, yeah, no maintenance at all. I gotta definitely say, this came from L.L. Bean a very long time ago, and never let us down. Great boat. The boss is trying the scrubby brush.
Look at it, it's working, some of it. See how some of it's coming off?
That's pretty amazing.
Yep.
It's quite honestly, I wasn't sure if that was going to come off or not, because that stuff's been on this poor boat for a long time.
There you have it. Look at. Those are black suds. Squid.
Nice. I think that's actually working. This is a tough boat. ABS plastic, so there's really not much that can happen to it other than getting melted. It's caught on fire, which is pretty unlikely.
Not bad, huh?
Yeah. All right, well, you want to take the power washer and blast that off, seeing as you took the time?
I can.
Yes. I think you should.
I'll go over here. Yeah.
Funny to see the difference in the color of the boat, because this red here is the original color. It's migrated to pink after years and years of being out in the sun. Yep. Yeah, it did.
Better?
Oh, that looks really good. Nice. Oh, come on. Good gravy, Ted. It's not that bad, dude. Ted thought the power washer was going to take him out. Nice.
Introducing the Coleman Ram X15. Ram because it's tough as hell. 15 because it's 15 feet long. X because, well, no idea on that. This beast was built back before the days of carbon fiber and feather-weighted composite materials spoke their first words. It's big, but it won't shatter on the first rock it says hello to. It probably weighs almost as much as the car you'll carry it on. On the bright side, it will carry two adults and a couple of kids chucked onto the floor. Probably also a couple of dogs if they're small and a little dumb. Only two of you can paddle, though, due to the included ultra-sweet two-part L.L. Bean paddle. Or if one of the two of you is really lazy, just leave it as a one-piece paddle and your significant other can yell commands from the bow. It comes with two flotation devices that might be good for sitting on, but I wouldn't trust them as a life-saving device. It doesn't come with an anchor, because, like the XN Valdez, this monster can't be stopped.
All right, I'm just going to use my little cleaning tip here. Making sure not to put my finger over the tip. There, that's pretty good. I'll see how this goes. Not well.